It should not be artificial, it should be natural. So I forget about you, okay? Now I am coming to the session. So stresses induced in pressure vessel due to an internal fluid pressure. Okay? If the load is tensile load, tensile stress will be induced in the material. If the load is compressive load, compressive stress will be induced in the material. Okay? So now, let me sketch the pressure vessel as a two-dimensional figure, like this. Imagine the pressure vessel, it is cylindrical in nature, the cross-section is circular cross-section. So like this, okay? So you listen, you all forget about that one, okay? You listen here. Now, the fluid pressure is P. So inside the pressure vessel, fluid is stored under pressure. Fluid is stored under pressure, okay? So now the pressure vessel sketch I have drawn as a two-dimensional figure. Now, as per Pascal's law, how the pressure force will be applied on the side of the pressure vessel wall in a perpendicular direction. So this fluid pressure is equal to force over area. Force over area, and from this force is pressure times area. So this fluid pressure can create this much magnitude of pressure force. You should not say simply force, it should be pressure force. It should be pressure force, and that will be applied in a perpendicular direction as per Pascal's law. It will be acting like this. It will be acting, okay, like this and like this. So remember, this pressure vessel, it is circular in cross section. The cross section is circular cross section, cylindrical in shape like this. Now, upward force, the fluid pressure, it is creating force, okay, all along the upward circumference as well as all along the downward circumference, isn't it? At the same time, it is the fluid pressure force acting on the side of the pressure vessel, side wall of the pressure vessel also. So this is how the pressure force is acting all along the side wall of the pressure vessel. Okay. Now from this, you can separate the force, pressure force which are acting on the upward direction and downward direction separately, and the pressure force acting on the side of the pressure vessel separately. Okay, let me do this. If the pressure vessel force, we are considering only the upward force and the downward force. This is upward force. This is downward. Okay? It is acting like this. Now, from this figure, it is easy to understand what kind of load this is, what kind of force this is, what kind of load or what kind of force is being applied when you consider upward force and downward force from this figure. Tensile load. But it is acting along the circumference. See, this is the horizontal pressure vessel. Okay, you imagine one half, another half. Okay, this is the circumference. The circumference will be like this. The fluid pressure force is acting in the upward direction all along the circumference, isn't it? Similarly, all along the circumference in the downward direction. Now the loading is, what kind of loading? A kind of tensile load. So, the load or pressure force is tensile load. Okay, tensile load. So the corresponding stress is tensile stress. Okay. So isn't it? If the load is tensile load, the corresponding stress induced in the material, cylinder material, is tensile stress, isn't it? So the corresponding stress is tensile stress. Right? Tensile stress. Now we identified from the upward force which is acting all along the circumference, and from the downward force which is acting all along the circumference, it is like tensile loading. So tensile stress will be induced in the pressure vessel material. This is what we identified, tensile stress. Clear? So this tensile stress, before the stress induced in the material, for this pressure force which is acting upward direction and downward direction, the pressure force is acting, what will be the reaction, initial reaction from the cylinder material? The cylinder material will try to produce equal amount of the opposite force opposite to this direction, isn't it? Clear? See, the pressure force is acting like this, here downward direction. This is cylinder material which is solid, okay? Cylinder material. Which is solid in nature. So the cylinder material will try to produce equal amount of resistive force in order to avoid deformation, isn't it? But once the pressure force, okay, I am telling here as pressure, which means this pressure can create this much force. Okay, initially the cylinder material will try to produce equal amount of resistive force, but this pressure force will increase further. What will happen? The resistive force from the cylinder material may not be sufficient. Then what will happen? Deformation begins. Still the pressure force increases further, deformation increases further. Once the pressure force increases drastically, okay, this cylinder, okay, will be splintered off into two pieces like this. The cylinder material will be splintered off like this because of the pressure force. See, this is how it is splintered into two pieces, right? So it is splitting along the longitudinal axis. So this is longitudinal axis. So because of this circumferential force, okay, so it is splitted along the longitudinal axis into two pieces. Got my point? Now assume that because of the pressure force, it is damaged, it is failed. It is failed, one half, another half, it is splintered separately. Now you want to attach together, okay? You want to attach together, you can make join over here with the help of welding. This is how you can join, okay? Now, because of the this tensile stress, this, let us give the name for this joint as longitudinal joint. Okay, now coming to this one, before the failure, because of the fluid pressure force, longitudinal joint failed, isn't it? Longitudinal joint failed. What is the stress induced here? Tensile stress. Okay, this tensile stress, we can name it as circumferential stress. Why? This is tensile load. From this figure, it is easy to understand. The load kind is tensile load. So the corresponding stress induced in the cylinder material is tensile stress. Now I am telling, this tensile stress is circumferential stress, because that tensile stress is acting all along the circumference of the cylinder. Got it? See, the circumference, upward forces which are acting in the upward direction, the circumference, imagine this is cylinder, all along the circumference, downwards direction also, all along the circumference it is acting. The tensile load is acting all along the circumference of the cylinder. So this tensile stress is circumferential stress. Now I am giving the name as sigma 1. Sigma 1 is circumferential stress, which is tensile in nature. Circumferential stress is tensile in nature. Because of the circumferential stress, what is this circumferential stress? It is created from the material, isn't it? Right? Okay. Now, because of this circumferential stress, longitudinal joint gets failed. Okay? I hope you can understand. Because of the circumferential stress, longitudinal joint gets failed. Okay? Now imagine if you have two pieces like this, okay, you can join these two pieces. Two pieces means one half spherical, one half of the cylinder, another half of the cylinder. You have like this after the failure. If you want to join together, okay, along the longitudinal joint, imagine this is longitudinal joint. Along this longitudinal joint, you can do welding process. Similarly, along this longitudinal joint, you can do welding process. Such a manner, you can attach together in order to form a cylinder. Okay, clear? Already I told you, when we discuss about shell, cell, how it is fabricated, it is not fabricated as a single cylinder unit. Okay, for the given radius, it is fabricated as a sector, and all the sectors, it is being attached with the help of welding process. Now imagine, because of this fluid pressure force, it is failed into two pieces, one half separately, another half separately. Now it is failed. Now how we can attach? You can attach along this longitudinal axis. Similarly, along this longitudinal axis with the help of welding process. What is the name of this joint? Once you have done the welding process, what is the name of this joint? Longitudinal joint. Okay? Longitudinal joint. How the failure is taking place along the longitudinal joint? Because of the circumferential stress, longitudinal joint is getting failed. Clear? Now, the same way, we consider only the upward force and downward force. Now let us consider this force which is acting on this side alone. Let us draw the figure which represents the fluid pressure force which is acting on this side of the wall. Like this. Okay. Now what kind of load here? The fluid pressure force will be acting like this. So, this much magnitude pressure force. Here everywhere fluid is filled. What kind of load this is from this figure? It is again tensile load. Again the loading is tensile load. Okay? The same explanation like stress. If you apply an external load, okay, the material also will try to produce equal amount of resistive force to avoid deformation. The same principle applied here. Tensile load, because of this fluid pressure force, this much magnitude, tensile load is applied like this and it is applied like this, tensile load. If you consider this as cylinder, here load is applied, pressure force, here also pressure force is being applied. So it is tensile loading. So what will happen from the material? The material immediately will not surrender to the pressure force. It will try to produce resistive force. Once the applied force and the resistive force will be equal, that is equilibrium condition, isn't it? Once the pressure force increases further, the resistive force from the material may not be sufficient to avoid deformation. So deformation begins. Now, if the pressure force which is acting on this side, increases drastically, what will happen? The cylinder material surrender to the upright force, the side force, and it will burst into two pieces. How? Because of this upward force, two of it splintered along the longitudinal axis. Now coming to this one, how the failure is possible for this tensile loading? It will break into two pieces like this, right? So it will break like this. Since the load is tensile load, the stress induced in the material is tensile stress. Here also. So here the load is acting along in which direction? This is tensile load. If you consider this one and this one, the load is tensile load. The load is acting along the longitudinal axis. This is tensile stress. The load is acting along the longitudinal axis. So this tensile stress will be longitudinal stress. And I am giving name letter as sigma 2. I hope you remember. Here it is also tensile load. Tensile load is acting all along the circumference. So the tensile stress is nothing but circumferential stress. Here the load is acting along the longitudinal axis. So the same tensile stress is nothing but longitudinal stress, that is sigma 2. Now what you have to understand? From the fluid pressure force, in pressure vessel, there are two stresses induced. One is circumferential stress, sigma 1, other one is longitudinal stress, sigma 2. Clear? This is right? So this is all about the stresses induced in pressure vessel due to an internal fluid pressure.